Haiti is a place that most of us only see when there's a disaster. Now it's the earthquake. What don't we see? What don't we know about Haiti?
First of all, I think Haiti is very complex. And even for us Haitian, it's very difficult to explain to somebody Haiti. Because it's like we have one country, and inside that country we have a lot of realities so different, so opposite, so contradictory, that it's very difficult to see in one visit or in one lifetime. So, and when people talk about Haiti, unfortunately, from the outside, they only see what is bad. They only see the misery, the poverty, the people who don't know how to read and write, and people who die of hunger. And now we have the earthquake. And the earthquake was like, wow, the world is looking at Haiti. And seeing what? Seeing exactly what was, you know, the media, the big media, that's what they show. They show Haiti is the poorest country of the hemisphere. That's the thing that they say about Haiti. And Haiti is much more than that. Haiti is also that. And we have to face the reality that Haiti is a poor country where people don't eat when they are hungry, where they don't have the basic. They have the basic to live a decent life. But Haiti is much more than that. And even the people in poverty know that Haiti is much more than that.
What is it?
Haiti is a country, first of all, where history is very strong. We have a history that is that shaped not only Haiti, but that shaped the world as it is. Because Haiti was one of the first countries to think about human rights. Not human rights as the French Revolution saw it. The human rights for the French Revolution were the white people. Haiti saw human rights as human. Dessalines said everybody is equal. Everybody, black, white, everybody is equal. And in that way, Dessalines was a visionary for his time. And the dignity of the Haitian people comes from that also. The history that shapes our way of life and shapes the way that the world sees us and treats us also. Because Haiti for the longest time, pays the price. It's still paying the price for the way the independence was conquered. Because it was a very, you know, unique experience for the French army to be defeated.
But how does Haitian literature and poetry reflect that history and culture?
I think many writers find a way to make history alive in their writing.
To make history come alive.
Come alive in their writing by not only when they write specifically about history, but by the way they refer to the heroes of the independence, of the revolutions. Mm-hmm. By the way the history is made into an everyday thing. In Haiti, people refer to history like it's, you know, past is yesterday's things.
Like people
like yes. So I think history is very much part of our lives, but also the culture. When I say culture, I say different elements, like the voodoo, even when you're not practicing voodoo, but voodoo is everywhere, even when you're not practicing. But we have traditions that are very related, associated with voodoo. And we have our music, our painting, and all these things are into the writings of the Haitian writers.